put your 3D glasses on then, pussy, because you know we coming straight at you.
PPV, live this motherfucker with that nigga Nasa, man. What's good, man?
Man, what's good, man? West Memphis, Arkansas, Zoom Crew Block shit, man. What's good with you, man?
Shit, you know what I'm saying? I had to reach out to my man's 100 grand posse pants. You know what I'm saying? You in Orlando right now.
Yeah, I'm in Orlando right now. Hit that airport as we speak, boy. Man, the Guardians of the Culture, man, they're all, man, put on one fucking hell of a show, man. I was a battle on Friday, and I was a fan on Saturday, bro. And I networked after. Yeah, man, that shit was high level. High level. I'm here to say, that day two was better than any event in battle rap this year, probably outside of town business day two. In my opinion.
That's a big statement, dog.
Yeah, and my people, one, watch when they drop, man, Twerk and Sway Devil. You telling me Sway Devil was talking to Twerk? You telling me Twerk showed up with Green Ram? You telling me what he's supposed to start off with? You came and he shut the building down.
Okay, before we get into it, let's run down these other battles. Hey, check this out. Check this out. I said, my man's excited about that shit. My nigga, yeah, nigga.
Yeah, I just had a thought in head. Yeah, that was the one, like, just because they're known entity to see classic versions of them, it gives people an idea that that's how that went. That event went like that. That was just a little sneak preview into the future. But I'm listening.
Okay.
You know how I get sometimes, brother.
I already know, bro. You know what I'm saying? But that shit real. That shit is real, though.
Yeah,
I'm good. Out the gate, so let's run through this day one card real quick. So you was present. Did you battle? You battled on the day one card, right?
Yeah, I was battling Colossus on the day one card.
Okay. So before we get to you, let's speak on Young Cannon versus Craig Lamar. Did that go down?
Yeah, that went down. That was a nice time. The day one crowd. I ain't gonna say they was a sleep crowd. It was like more of a listener crowd. Like, you know, the event was surrounded around, like, you know, what I was just saying with Sway, Stubborn, Squirt, and shit like that. So a lot of people was kind of looking at people like, so when you, by the time they got to Craig Lamar and Young Cannon, it's getting later, you know, you got that, like, the main event crowd. But they was cooking, though. You know what I'm saying? They was cooking. It was Young Cannon versus Craig Lamar. You know what I'm saying? It was cooking. I think Cannon had a slight tumble in the second. Greg Lamar jerseyed out his third number 30. I like that battle.
Okay, who you had as a winner? Nice, who you got as a winner?
I don't know if you win this live unless it was clear. I don't think that really was a clear one. I think Craig Lamar won. But like my personal opinion, I would have to watch that again.
Okay.
Because it wasn't so just apparently clear. You know what I'm saying? Because Young Cannon messed up, and it was like, okay, yeah. Because he was talking about Craig Lamar being all fucked up and choking. He messed up, and then, like, Craig Lamar kind of jerseyed out. Like, kind of faked us with, like, he thought I was fucking up, and then he really was, like, fucking up. Yeah, so, you know what I'm saying? So, like, that's how that went.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's how that went. But to me, that's one of the ones that you have to watch and decide for yourself.
Okay, 100. There it is. So let's go with my OG Quest McCody and that boy Ro, man. How'd that go, man?
Oh, man, that motherfucker was classic. You know, that was when I had my whole energy change. So, like, that motherfucker, Ro inspired, and that was the best Quest McCody in the long fucking time. Like, that nigga, man, I can't wait till y'all see that one. Ro, that battle went down the road because he faced a Quest McCody people ain't seen in a while. They don't want to watch it. You know, when you're trying to get your name out here, people are putting the known hitter. That's if they snap, but then they're going to see Ro at the same time. And that's one of them. Now, when you're dealing with up-and-comers, the winners and losers is how the battle went down.
Mm-hmm.
Only can lose if the battle's strong, you were strong. Right? Yeah, Ro, there's no way Ro loses that. There's no way Quest McCody loses that. That was classic. Like, I put my work, we all watched that. Y'all gonna be like, yeah, this motherfucker wrote snapping and quest for Tony, what the fuck? Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how I was. Yeah, them niggas won all three rounds. There was no smacking round. All three. And they was one of the two battles that had the crowd. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, they had the crowd. Yeah, the crowd woke up for them.
Okay.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Now you just gonna call that one dead even. You gonna Tupac that. You gonna toss that one up?
Yeah, man. That motherfucker, yeah. That was one of the ones. I like that. That's gonna be a great, you know what I'm saying? It's like me versus Danny Myers. That was great for me.
Mm.
That's gonna be great for Ro. That's it. Quiz for Cody. Yo, that nigga, man. Can't wait to sound business too. See that work he put in. And if he rapped it like that, that's a dangerous quiz. Very dangerous quiz.
Fire.
That's a very dangerous quiz. Yeah, that's
good to hear. I had to hear what Quest did, you know what I'm saying? That's the big homie and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Man, that nigga was fire, bro. I'm talking about the best Quest in years, bro. My word.
Okay. I'm gonna take your word on that, nigga.
Man.
That's dope.
That's the word around the, you know what I'm saying? That everybody watched. I guess the common thought, like, that's the best question. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Type of thing. Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
That nigga hungry now. Y'all got him fucked up.
That's the real big homie. So shout out, salute to that boy, Ro. Shout out, salute to that boy, Quest. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it looked like Mags and Spider Murphy versus Lexington Ave.
Isaac Knox.
And Isaac Knox and Josh Mosh Jelton.
Isaac Knox, my boy. I had Isaac Knox win. That's my boy. You know what I'm saying? So fuck me, bro. So that's my guy. You know what I'm saying? KLTD shit, GV shit. But Isaac Knox is the main stage. He has a main stage feel to me. He came out rebuttaling in the tag team, and the rebuttals were hitting. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
And I like him. He was the standout at the whole battle. That was a nice battle, but Isaac Knox was the standout. So for me, when you have somebody that stand out like that, it gives them the win to me when I'm watching live. Like, yeah, he was so different than anybody else who had a part, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's like in my mind, because a lot of stuff went down. So my memory, I just remember things that made an impact. Isaac Knox stood out to me. You know what I'm saying? He got the look size, the photo ability. His punches come off clean. You could tell that him and his opponent they was using their styles and that. They didn't do that thing where it sounded like two people rapping one person's shit. It was two different styles that I did not stood out. He was doing his shit. His partner was doing their shit. The people they went against was kind of like was doing the NWX thing, like where basically it's you're trying to intertwine, but it was a for me not to, like, know them that well, I couldn't pick out who was who. You know what I mean?
Okay.
It sounded like it was the same person rapping. I did not spoke with the monotony of the whole battle. And yeah, so, yeah, I give that to him and his partner.
Okay.
Like, that was stood out in my mind.
That's 100. That's your opinion. You know what I'm talking about? So, shout out, salute
that's
to the
right, right.
You know what I mean? So, we got Young Knox, the nigga, versus what's this nigga name? Killisus?
Man, Colossus.
Colossus.
Like the weirdest fucking name in the fucking world.
Yeah, that man, that spelling threw me off, dog. You hear me?
Yeah. This battle, for me, I say, when I walk off stage and motherfuckers telling me they fans of mine, I won. Yeah, be fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Uncle Ron, fuck with me, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Shout out to all 15 minutes of fame, they was fucking with me, you know what I'm saying? He was fucking with the battle because, like, when I was talking about the crowd reaction, it was apparent in that battle that my bar level was super high. To the point, I talk shit when I rap. You ain't give me no reaction, I'm talking shit to y'all, you know what I'm saying? But, like, they was fucking with us, you know what I'm saying? We was fucking with them back, though. Like, that battle was high energy, high. Everybody was saying it after the battle. I'm like, you motherfuckers telling me this shit after the battle, you know what I'm saying? I was reacting. You know what I'm saying? But that was the type of crowd it was. They was listening. Okay, let's see what they got. And they understood that, but coming back telling us, man, that shit was fire. Bar for bar, man. The battle was nice to the point. Like, cause the bars was there. The energy was there. People telling about my performance. You know, I'm a unique guy when you beat me. Rap, you know what I'm saying? I got a different energy. So, like, and I started showing off my skill set, and they was reacting to the rebuttal, the freestyle. Like, he threw, for example, he threw Kid Galaxy at me, right? Twice. The crowd going crazy, the third round, right? The round when you say, fuck it, we're going to react to each other. These motherfuckers looking at us too much, you know what I'm saying? But they loving it. You can tell they loving it, but they want to. Nigga, we aggressive. Nigga, when I say a punchline, I want to react. Not just go, move. So, like, he threw Kid Galaxy at me, throw a whole unit of things at me. Twice. So they go off of that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I said, you wanna know how I know you a faggot? It's all for the fucker, cause you and your niggas be talking to each other. They shut down. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Shit like this. In that moment, like, I felt like if you ask somebody, what do you remember from Colossus and that, they're gonna say my rebuttals. I stood out with the rebuttals. I showed the skill that my opponent didn't possess in that battle. And I just saw him as haymakers. So that's how I feel, personally. But Colossus did his thing. He was snapping, bro. Like, that nigga got bars. I got bars. I love battles like that. And we had fans, and they was new fans of mine. You know what I'm saying? Man, I was doing photo ops after that shit.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, man. I was like, damn. Okay, motherfuckers. It was nice for y'all to react when we was doing the shit. But, you know, you could tell that the shit was like, it was high bar level, so they was listening to the bars. They really was giving us more reaction than we could give credit for. We just wanted everything. You know what I'm saying? I want all of it.
Hell yeah.
But it was,
I want
all that shit.
What the fuck?
You know what I'm saying?
Need it all,
bro. Yeah, but what you talking about? Yeah, but like, you were like, when it's happy, you watch it, you're gonna love it. Because the energy, and always say when you battle, you gotta have those qualities when people can say, yeah, I see them on main stage. And people was walking up telling me that. Like, even when day two was going on, I had other battles that fans was like, because I'm reacting like a fan, right? You see how hype from them. And they was like, bro, you on that level as them too. You know what I'm saying? So I was getting that kind of love. You know what I'm saying? So, like, yeah, I love that battle. I'm over Colossus, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, but I won that motherfucker because I got fans on. I can't lose a battle I made fans off of.
Okay. Yeah. So you bossed up and showed that boy, this rebuttal, boy, this shit real, boy. What the fuck you talking about, boy?
Yeah, because your people gonna say you up, my people gonna say I'm on, but the people in the middle would watch that motherfucker, I'm like, damn, that nigga could rebuttal. And freestyle, you know, I got that thing that a lot of people missing, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
That thing that people miss, because I was more, and I was fresher. So sometimes when you dress better, you win. People simple. But the bitches watching the battle, ooh, I like that light skin nigga.
Out the gate. This ain't real niggas.
Yeah,
skills.
Out the gate, yeah. Yeah, marketability is key too. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So like that's that on that, yeah, but I like that battle.
Okay, so 100, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to that boy. What's that nigga name again? Colossus?
That Colossus, man.
Colossus. You know Colossus, what I'm saying? Yeah.
Man, yeah.
So let's speak about that Ron Compton and Red LaFleur.
Man, Ron Compton, bro. Hey, they better start sleeping on Ron Compton, man. That nigga, man. That man's so lyrical, bro. He got the, I don't get is that when the crowd don't react, I got to stop and let them motherfuckers know. Man, Ron Compton's smooth ass and not give a fuck. He made them fall in love with his balls. Like, he was going so intricate that everybody just had to, like, hold on. Like, he had that kind of reaction. Like, they had to stop him. Because he kept on giving it to him, like, man, welcome to get balls for real. Like, he had intricate, like, daylight, like, you know what I'm saying? That inner layer, like, damn, how the fuck you nigga think about this type of shit? You know what I'm saying? And he made that crowd react to him. Like, to the point, he won his battle clearly. But you know what I'm saying? His name is in my mind, his opponent.
Ray LaFleur.
His comfortability, like fighting through the lack of reaction, was Ron Compton looked like he was smooth sailing. As he rapped, he wasn't relying on the crowd. You know what I'm saying? And it was apparent that Ron Compton had a better voice system, but the type that if you keep listening, it's going to make you react. So that's how I felt about that battle. Both of them was fire, though. It didn't look like twins. He called
boy, nigga, oh God.
He called him Warren Campbell. You know what I'm saying? Like, some nigga from Campbell.
Well, they look like them niggas. They look like them the albino niggas from the second Matrix, nigga. Them niggas with the dread. That's what them niggas look like.
The ghost niggas.
I swear. The ghost, they go through trucks and shit. That's them niggas, boy. So, dope battle overall. But you said you got Ron Compton.
Yeah, I got Ron Compton clearly because the comfortability in the way, when you watch, you know what I mean. Like, and that's not taking nothing from Clear. Just that night and that moment, it was apparent that, like, yeah, Ron Compton got it. You know what I'm saying? Like, he don't need to be slept on. Like, you know how Excel gets slept on sometimes because he got that smooth flowing, but he's deep. Like, mm-hmm. He got that
tactic. He be barking.
On. Like, don't. Yeah, don't sleep on this guy type of thing. Like, it's apparent. Like, he'll have, give him his exposure that he's been doing. If he keeps doing what he's doing, he gonna have niche fans that just does his shit because he say shit for niggas who love to think, and it's worth listening to him. It's worth breaking his bars down to see what he hid in there for you. Like, the little treats he give thinkers, you know what I'm saying, on footage. That nigga hard, bro.
Okay.
Facts.
Okay, I'm going to check that when it drop, you know what I'm saying? So, shout salute to the guys. Lord Sparks versus Ghost.
That probably was, other than Roe and Quest McCody, the battle of the night. They shared that one. Both of them guys was going off. That's one you can't call. They doggone online who won. They think, some people think Ghost lost. I don't think so. Because Ghost had performed plenty. Sparks has had balls in the, like, the Haitian feeling comes from his authentic, like, both of them had believability after that. Both of them had presence, like, crazy. The crowd was reacting to them, too. I think their presence helped a lot. Like, you know what I'm saying? And then, like, you know, they had people in the building for them, both of them. You know what I'm saying? It seemed like they fought with each other, too. So, like, I don't know their history, but it just felt like this was one, like, yeah, we want to see this. Yeah, and both of them wanted to see what each other do against each other. I think they matched each other. You know what I'm saying? I see, like, smart people like, yeah, he killed Ghost. I don't think so. Ghost fired. You know, so both of them was fired. I can't call that one.
Okay.
That's what's going to be for people to decide, or that fan base is going to pick the other.
Yo.
So, you know what I'm saying? Both of them can say that to each other. That shit was fire. That was.
All right, you went out for a second because I didn't hear some of the shit you said because your phone went out.
My phone went out. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now, G.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, you good money.
Yeah. That's one of the ones that both of their fan bases broke that. They just cuss each other out and say the other one won with their full heart. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, Ghost won. You know what I'm saying? Both of them went, that's how they went in. I like that one. That was like the cold battle of the night.
Okay. Okay, so you gonna toss that one up. Okay.
Yeah,
I got
you.
So,
Nah,
this is all about you. You know what I'm saying? Tupac voice. It's right, all about man. You. You know what I'm talking about? Real shit. So, Mike, Billy Black.
That one, I went out and I saw the first round, and Mike got the first. And I forgot why I had to go out. And I ain't get to see that one. I fuck with Mike though. And I fuck with Homie Black. I fuck with both of them. I just know Mike had the first, but like what I was hearing about the battle was a nice battle. You know what I'm saying? So I can't call it, but I know Black Hard anyway. Like, I fuck with him before him because of the event.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Yeah, I fuck with him for the. So he won, because that's my name. And Mike was making jokes about me on Facebook Live before the event. So Black won that hoe. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Black won all of the 3-0.
30 ball, okay.
Man. Yeah, 30. 30 in a bad, too.
30.
Mike was there the whole event. You know, I make up some shit for that one.
Yeah,
Mike was just sad. Now, Mike Cooper don't have my own.
You're fried.
I just honestly did. I just had the first round. I had Mike taking that first, but I didn't see the rest of the battle.
Okay.
But Black is fired.
Except
on guard head-to-head. I think Mike might win against Lavish. I think, yeah, Mike versus Lavish was a battle on last time. So I'm going to shout them out with a battle for people because I can give a full recap.
That's one.
On that joint.
That's solid. That's solid as hell, my mama. You know what I'm saying? So, RK and what's this nigga name? Mike Ray. McNasty?
McNasty. Yo, the Pauls King. That nigga is the Pauls, the Puerto Rican Pauls King. That's the Puerto Rican. That nigga has so many Pauls. He was fucked up like he had this, you know, this, like he was a New Yorkian, like Puerto Rican, like high level of sarcasm. Like, he didn't give a, like, he was giving his balls, like, I don't give a fuck about you. Oh, you motherfuckers listening. But it was entertaining. You know, so he had this character that I like.
Okay.
You know, but Arcane is different. Arcane won that battle, let me. Arcane has this bomb. And my brain said it, but it's almost a compliment. He has this old school grind time flow. But it works. He got like this, like one bang on his head. White boy with a bang, yeah, heavy metal. But it fits who he is. It's hard to beat somebody who you know is being themselves. They look like themselves. He got his own unique presentation flow. I think once he keeps battling and people start recognizing, Arcane is one of those guys that I can see in the cult following because he's just that different.
Mm.
And really, both of them had differences. I like that Arcane's different better because he wasn't saying gay shit. He wasn't saying gay bars. You know what I'm saying? The Paul's bars on his money so many times. Like, I'm for like toilet humor, you know, every now and then. But like, Arcane was serious with what he was saying. And then he was that third round, he was doing his multis, you know, sometimes the crowd, I don't go by the crowd all the time I go to where my ears are, and Arcane was multis, doing these multis where he was breaking down Migraine. He had this whole bar about Migraine saying that I'm over here, and he put that motherfucker down like on some Ill Mac versus Big K shit.
Mm.
Yeah, hit him with it, with a punch at the end of it. With his name, with the Migraine, he just summed it up to a Migraine. Like, bro, like, that dude's different, man. Okay, yeah, I'll take that one to me, but, like, Migraine was hard, so he'll have a fan base full of people who love what he do, but he had, like, I don't give a fuck, man. He don't give a fuck, he's not listening to this. Like, bro, I don't give a fuck with that shit. I want this shit. Like, I like, he that type of guy. I like that type of
okay.
person. Yeah, I like that battle, though. I like that battle.
So you said you got RK with that one, right?
Yeah, I got RK because I like him. You know, that one could be debatable, but like when I like somebody's style, I'm biased towards what he was doing. For me personally, I like what he was doing. And I'm, you know, I'm in KOTD. I know that style works there. He needs to, you know, so I can see him on that main stage.
Solid.
That's how I look at that. Yeah.
Solid.
I like RK.
Solid.
Yeah,
so let's talk about Jermaine TED. Versus got that. Hold on, man. I ain't even say the other nigga name, man. Goddamn, man. Can I say the other mind, man?
That's
one
of the things.
This nigga, man. Hold on, let's try this again, dog. We got TED versus, what is the nigga name? Zed or Zaid?
That is Zay.
Okay, Zay. Now go ahead, bro. Ted won. Go ahead, man.
Yeah. Ted won the first round. Zay won the second round. And Ted won the third round. I remember this battle very vividly. Zay's second round was fire as fuck. So I don't want to say nothing to Zay. He was ill prepared in the third. But then what he was getting in, he fucked up. But then when he was getting out, Ted would have won the third anyway. But I think it could have been like a great, great, great battle to watch if Zay didn't mess up in the third. So both of them did their thing. But Ted, man, they had this thing about him, bro. He from Orange Brown, man. He misses his fuck. Mm. Man, that's my nigga.
Orange Brown, man.
Man, come on, man. This man.
Man.
You know what I think. I'm telling the people what I think about that, man. They got main stage quality, man. Like, believability out the door. And he's intelligent behind him. Like, his balls are intellectual. He don't rap out like his image would suggest that he would rap. He's intellectual. You know what I mean? He's like one of those people that prove, like, the stereotype's not true type of motherfucker. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, he won't no Lakers, man. He give it a different. Like, he got a package with, like, you know what I'm saying? He's bindable on any stage. KOTD, you know what I'm saying? Like, KOTD, URL, whatever stage you want to put on, I bet on Ted. That's why he tagged Tina, man, in Canada next week.
I seen that, man.
This week, brother.
I seen that, man.
Yeah, man.
Congratulations.
Yeah, appreciate that, bro. You know what I'm saying? We're going to put it in work, but, like, I trust Ted. You know what I'm saying? I like what he do. We got great chemistry. He had great chemistry with himself and his rap. You can tell that he's just being himself. It's no question when you watch Ted, like, is he learning? No, that's Ted. You see in Ted, you're like the same guy rapping, the same guy you're going to talk to rapping about, the same guy fucking with you on Facebook.
Yeah, that nigga Ted funny to a bitch. Oh, God.
Yeah, that's the nigga, man.
He got a dope personality, bro. Could I have rapped to him, like, on the jack before? You know what I'm saying? Like, he got a dope fucking personality, bro. That's on God.
Yeah, he the one got me traveling. You know what I'm saying? Like, I told him, before all this, your personality won't get you far. And that's what he did. And he helped me up. Like, people fuck with me because they fuck with him.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I get a chance to meet people because, you know, Ted already knew them, and they like, okay, if you fuck with Ted, I'll fuck with you.
Yeah,
and they
yeah,
see us
yeah.
fucking around on Facebook, like, you know what I'm saying? You know, the touch on social media make people mad to have fun. You know what I'm saying? And Ted, he one of them people that's going to get far, man, because not only is he talented, but he's a good person to be around. So, facts.
That's dope.
That's my homie, man.
Yeah, so shout out to that boy, man. Ted. You know what I'm saying? So, want to talk about this day, too? That's how you feel. That's how you feel, G. You know what I'm saying?
Put your 3D glasses on, then, pussy, because you know we coming straight at you.